Massage cupping first gained big attention with Michael Phelps at the 2016 Olympics when the championship swimmer sported those telltale circles on his back. Since then, cupping has become a bit of a celebrity hallmark. But East West College campus president Russ Battiata and MSOM program chair Brandon Fuller are here to tell us that massage cupping has a deep and international history, and it's being done right here on the Suncoast. Welcome back to both of you.
Thank you.
Brandon, help us understand the concept of cupping. What exactly is it?
So cupping is the use of small jars, as you see on the table here. We have glass, but we also have plastic. And there's a suction or a vacuum that's created, and we place it over an area of discomfort on the skin. And that suction and vacuum creates a blood flow into that area. So it's breaking up any stagnant blood that might be stuck in a muscle and helping bring in fresh blood to heal an injured area.
It's kind of the opposite of maybe traditional massage, where you're pushing an area to move the blood.
Right.
So how does this kind of inversely do the same thing?
This part's kind of cool. The latest research actually shows that when we place the cup on and we create that vacuum over the skin, we're creating almost like this little micro trauma in the area, and it's encouraging the body to create new blood vessels. So a microvascularization happens, and that vascularization increases the blood flow to the area.
Okay.
So you have a better healing experience.
Now, Russ, this may be new to us in the past few years, but the concept actually dates back a really long time.
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit about the history and how that actually ties into everything at East West College.
Well, you know, this is a practice that dates back to the 1500s, and they used to use hollowed out animal horns and their suction properties over infected tissues to remove the tissue. And so then they progressed to using bamboo shoots to certain areas of the body, and they found a therapeutic and healing element to it. And that evolved to what we see today. We've been doing it at East West for over 20 years. It was made popular in 2016 with the Olympics.
Right.
And he spoke about the microvascularizations and all of those bruises or spots that you see on people's backs, and kind of find it cool when you go to the beach. But there are natural healing properties associated with it. And when you combine it with an acupuncture treatment, you get even more healing out of it.
So, okay, now with the marks that it does leave, obviously because of the suction, I'm not going to lie, it looks like it hurts. So Joey has volunteered to find out if it really does.
Let's see.
Maybe I volunteered him, I don't know. So we're just going to do it on your arm.
Yeah.
But I'm very curious as to how the procedure works.
So it's very non-eventful. We like the non-eventful terms, right? So all we do, I brought a pumped suction cup. We just place it over an area.
Okay.
And we give it a couple of pumps.
Ooh, your skin is bubbling.
And
right.
It creates that vacuum, right?
All right.
How's that feel
for you? I was going to say, what do you
hurt.
Feel?
It really doesn't hurt, no.
Right, and so what we can do is we can remove this and it stays on there, it won't move.
Oh wow, now how long for treatment purposes do you leave a cup in place?
Between 5 and 10 minutes.
Okay, so if I were, say, working on my upper back or my back on my shoulders, I would lay down and then you would place how many cups on, typically?
Generally, we take a look, we see what area needs to be worked on. It may be between 3 to 6 cups, it might be a couple more. It really depends on what's going on, but then it's left for about 5 to 10 minutes.
And do I get a rub down once it is over, or does the trauma need to stay isolated in that spot?
In general, at the college, we always tend to end it off with a nice little massage, and we put a nice little healing liniment on there.
Yeah. Yeah. Is that part of today? I mean, you can see that it's, you know, you can see the skin goes up. I know it does look like it hurts, but it really doesn't hurt.
It doesn't hurt.
It doesn't. Yeah.
And then I see it, you know, a little discoloration beginning. We're actually secretly hoping he gets a really big
circle. I can tell you that I know.
Is that simply the blood flow that is causing that?
It's like when you create that suction effect, it has that that kind of micro trauma effect, creating a bruise. So it's like it's almost like if you bumped your arm and you go, oh, it's no big deal, and you get a tiny little bruise, there's a little bit of a micro trauma.
That's very interesting how quickly it happens.
Yeah.
I mean, that was only probably about a minute and a half, and we were already seeing that.
Yeah.
So, Brandon, tell us, at
East-West, you are not only performing this so that people can come and get the treatment, but you're also training teachers, and Russ, is that correct?
Yeah, we're training students to learn this practice along with many other methodologies to become acupuncture physicians, and to where they can actually do cupping on their patients. And it's very easy to enroll. All you have to do is contact us, go on our website. We'll go bring you in, take you for a tour. You'll see our student clinic, our herbal pharmacy, and you'll be able to actually be cupped.
All right, and that sounds great. So this is Eastern Medicine coming to us here on the Suncoast. And for more information about these treatments in the natural medicine fields, you can go to East West College's website. That is ewcollege.edu. All right, Joey, we're going to keep an eye on that.